Hawk Wasp versus Huntsman Spider. Who would win in a fight? Size isn't everything. This isn't a battle of giants, it's a battle of some tiny creatures. But the level of deadly that they possess is giant. The Hawk Wasp and the Huntsman Spider, the punch they pack for their sizes, they really make every ounce count. But what if these little scary guys were pitted against each other? Who would emerge victorious? Forget about the heavyweight matchups, we're looking at the featherweight division. This is the Hawk Wasp versus the Huntsman Spider, and we're going to figure out who would win. Let's meet the Hawk Wasp first and learn what he's all about. The Hawk Wasp is also known as a spider wasp or a tarantula hawk. Right off the bat, that gives you an idea of why this creature is so terrifying. Tarantulas are already scary creatures to most, and this wasp preys on tarantulas. The Hawk Wasp is one of the largest living wasps. They can grow to be 2.5 inches long. The stinger of the female alone is usually 0.5 inches. The Hawk Wasp uses that stinger in a horrifying way. You do not want to fall victim to the Hawk Wasp. It will use that stinger to paralyze its prey, but it won't kill it. It will drag it back to its nest as living food. While the prey remains paralyzed, the Hawk Wasp will lay an egg on top of it, and its baby will then hatch from the egg and begin to eat the still living prey. But when the egg is laid on the spider, it creates a small hole in the abdomen for the babies to crawl inside to eat. They avoid the major organs as long as possible to keep the spider alive as long as possible. It is one of the worst imaginable endings. The Hawk Wasp is ruthless. That sting of the Hawk Wasp is considered one of the most powerful stings in the entire animal kingdom. In fact, it's only second to the bullet ant. Interestingly enough, the Hawk Wasp in its adult stages is nectarivorous, meaning it feeds on the nectar of flowers. Their diet is mainly coming from the flowers of milkweeds, mesquite trees, western soapberry trees, and other similar flowers. It's only the young of the Hawk Wasp that will feed on another animal. So the Hawk Wasp isn't feeding on tarantulas, but it is preying on them for its young. Still, you do not want to be in the wrong side of the Hawk Wasp. So, does the Huntsman Spider make an exception to that rule? The Huntsman Spider is another animal known by several names. It is sometimes referred to as Wood Spider or a giant crab spider, which is a horrifying visual. But that is the visual you have when you come across a Huntsman Spider. They are enormous and have the appearance of a crab. Want to know how big? They can often reach sizes of 9.8 to 11.8 inches long. Sometimes people confuse Huntsman Spiders with tarantulas, but they are not related. They tend to stand out from their long crab-like legs that extend out in a different, almost twisted fashion. The 8 eyes of the Huntsman Spider are in 2 forward-facing rows of 4. Their bodies are smooth and furry, but their legs feature prominent spines. Not anything you want to touch either way. Especially since they have bites that are extremely painful. They can become aggressive, especially the females, when defending their young. Huntsman spiders use venom as well, something that is used to immobilize their prey or as self-defense if they feel threatened. Believe me, you don't want to make them feel threatened. If the aggression, the venom, and the painful bite weren't enough to deter you, let's revisit the size. 11.8 inches may not sound so big, but when you compare it to the fact that it could be the size of a dinner plate, that puts it more into perspective. Most people get scared of a spider that is the size of their finger. Take a look at a dinner plate and imagine it to be a spider crawling towards you. That is a Huntsman spider. It is the largest spider in the world in terms of leg span. Oh, did we mention they're fast? That's an added terror for the creepy creature. Because if you see it and it's on the move, don't expect that you'll have plenty of time to react. Huntsman spiders are different from many spiders in that they don't build webs to catch their prey. No, they don't sit back and idly wait by. Instead, they take on the meaning of their name. They go and hunt down their prey. It's aggressive and it takes action. Can the Huntsman spider get any scarier? Now that we've explored 2 horrifying little creatures, what happens when we put them together? Is it possible for the Hawk Wasp and the Huntsman spider to ever cross paths? Well, the Hawk Wasp is found on all continents with the exception of Europe and Antarctica. They are predominant in the U.S. deserts in the southwest, like in California, Arizona, and New Mexico, where it is actually the state insect. They are common in many desert environments, since that is where tarantulas are found. Huntsman spiders are found in warmer climates. They are found all over the continents of Asia, Africa, and Australia. They have also shown up in plenty of warmer U.S. states like Florida, Texas, and California. So it appears these two share plenty of common ground. A meetup is inevitable. And in fact, a meetup isn't just inevitable, it's already happened. Plenty of times. Many people have witnessed hawk wasps and huntsman spiders face off. The hawk wasp is everywhere but Europe and Antarctica, so they have plenty of overlap in Asia, Africa, Australia, and some of the states in America. One place that we know they have met up often is right in the Golden State, California. Now, the huntsman spider has the size advantage. It is a powerful spider. It is large. It is fast. It can use all of those things to jump the hawk wasp. A huntsman spider absolutely could take advantage of striking first. It is an aggressive spider, a take-action spider, as we mentioned. In fact, hawk wasps tend to be docile, only going after tarantulas when they need to feed their young. So if the spider in question is the huntsman spider, it just needs to act first. And they are jumpers, by the way. But like we said, they need to act first, because if a huntsman spider doesn't seize its first opportunity to attack that hawk wasp, it is done. The hawk wasp has the second most painful sting on planet Earth. Don't forget, it is paralyzing, so completely paralyzing, that once it hits a target with that half an inch stinger, they are stuck. And though a huntsman spider is larger than the hawk wasp, it isn't so much larger, just several inches. The venom in the stinger of the hawk wasp is so dooming that the spider will be immobilized for far too long. Once it is hit, that's the end. The hawk wasp has the advantage of not only having a stronger stinger with longer lasting paralyzing effects, but the length of that stinger is a big key too. Think of it like two boxers, and one has a longer reach. If that hawk wasp can get one strike in with that longer reach, that's all it takes. It's like a one-hit knockout punch. Far too often, people have seen hawk wasps go up against huntsman spiders, and far too often it is the same story again and again. It stings the huntsman spider, and the spider is frozen, and the hawk wasp picks it up and drags it away. People have seen hawk wasps carrying huntsman spiders over 10-foot walls. They've seen them carry them off great distances, because now the hawk wasp has something. It has food for its young. The huntsman spider may be more aggressive and may be able to use that to its advantage. And a hawk wasp being more docile may be perceived as a disadvantage. But what's a bigger driving force than the huntsman spider's aggressive nature is the love of a parent for its child. If the hawk wasp senses it can get a meal for its babies, then that spider just became really unlucky. We give this battle to the hawk wasp almost every time, because people have seen this happen all too often. One sting and it's all over. But the huntsman spider isn't without a chance. Again, they'd need to act early and fast, and they'd need to avoid that stinger. Their best defense would probably be to never approach a hawk wasp, because the hawk wasp has a distinct advantage. This isn't just a battle to be won. This is a meal to be earned for the kids.